All right, Mauricio. I've been hanging out all morning in the office telling some stories. Coach Jensen's got the oldest phone in NCAA wrestling.
Yes, he does. I agree.
So you are the head assistant here at San Francisco State.
Yes.
And the most successful wrestler in the history of the program.
Yes.
Four-time All-American, two-time NCAA champ. And I, you know what? You're like one of those guys. You're like of myth and folklore. I walk up to you and I'm like, this guy won NCAAs at 184. And you're about 5'8", right?
Yeah, I'm about, 5'8".
So you won two titles at 84 and All-American twice at 74.
Twice at 74s, two national champions at 84.
All right. Well, we talk about it. I talked about it with Jason Borelli, and he says that oftentimes we hire guys who were a four-time All-American, such as you, a two-time NCAA champ, and they don't always relate to the student-athletes the best. How do you relate to the student-athletes? And you know, how are you bridging the gap, being this, you know, tremendous athlete from Folsom, California? And how are you able to relate to athletes after a four-time All-American finish?
Well, first of all, being here on this campus, this is the campus that I went to, you know, so I understand the campus well. And I wasn't a kinesiology major. I was a cinematography major, so I was already kind of outcasted and made me kind of unique with wrestling. So I got to experience a little bit more of the campus and also be able to wrestle and do that part. And so now with my student athletes, I'm able to explain to them how to live beyond just the mats. And that also helps them develop all the different components mentally that need to come in place to be successful as an athlete. So that's that component. And then as a wrestler, I think I'm pretty humble. And the idea that, you know, keeping our wrestlers humble and taking each win, you know, in one step at a time, each loss in one step at a time, not to get too high or too low off of each one, and to grow from everything they do on the mat, and that will help develop them into champions.
Okay, I saw a picture of you hitting the sidewalk slam. What is the sidewalk slam?
The sidewalk slam, it's a finish, a double leg. It's simply a step through.
Inside trip, basically?
It's an inside trip. Yeah, it's an inside trip. I run it off of, really it ends up being a high C that turns into a double and then ends up being an inside step through finish. I'm probably not able to do it anymore.
Really? You think you can? I know you can.
Maybe. Somebody'd have to bring it out of me.
Do you still, when you roll with these guys, can you still strap it up and beat guys up how you want to?
I think so, yeah. Yeah, you can ask them. They call me old has-been. And it's difficult as a coach. You don't go 100% as a coach all the time. I think any coach can tell you that. Any successful wrestler who is now a coach could tell you that you don't just go out and destroy your wrestlers, because that totally destroys their confidence. But what you do is you go out and you give them opportunities to work while challenging them at the same time. So I'm hardly in positions now where I just go out and destroy them. You know, something had to go really wrong, or
they had
or
to maybe punch you in the face or hit you in the nose, huh?
Yeah. Or maybe they need to be humbled. Maybe they've had too much success, right? And they need to be brought back to become tournament ready, need to be humbled a little bit, and then I could turn it on. But for the most part, we're learning. I'm challenging them, putting them in very difficult positions, but not trying to destroy them.
Do you see yourself at 53 years old? I think that's in 23 years. You're 30 now. Mm-hmm. Do you see yourself at 53 like Lars Jensen still wrestling?
I'm very impressed that that Lars has the enthusiasm that he has at this age, and even after being the head coach for so long. It's not an easy task. You know, it can become very rudimentary coming in the room for so many years doing the same kind of thing, and you get different athletes who challenge you in different types of ways. It can be difficult. So I'm impressed with that. At 53, yeah, I hope so. I definitely would be in the physical condition to do it at 53. Hopefully mentally I'll still be enthusiastic about wrestling in that way.
He's 53 years old, and we see a lot of times in wrestling, we see coaches stagnate by the time, you know, they hit 50 years old. Right. And it's a young man's game, you know, NCAA wrestling is for sure. But three All-Americans last year, a top 20 finish, mm-hmm. and it looks like you guys are gearing up, bringing back multiple All-Americans, mm-hmm. Multiple-time All-American in Naveed. When you guys see that and you're sustaining, and wrestling is in trouble in California, do you see him as still the positive fit for San Francisco State?
Yes, right now it's I think it's working out. I know he doesn't want to be here forever. He's doing the things in the background. It's humbling being a head coach, you know, because you're not out there trying to destroy your athletes You're doing all the things in the background to make sure that your program stays together, that your athletes are successful, and that when you leave, things will still be able to operate and stay together. And that's what he's doing. He's doing all this background work, making sure that when he leaves, it doesn't all crumble and fall apart. And that's a commendable task. And so I think since he has so much experience with the school, with the university, and with the administration, and with the alumni, yes, he's the best fit for the position.
Do you guys continue? You know, what's the goal, honestly, next year for you guys? What do you guys see next year? Come bringing all Americans back, had three this year. What do you guys see as the goals reasonably for San Francisco State?
We still need to make a lot of growth. We still have to grow quite a bit. We will have a bit of a young team coming in, actually. Even though we have some strong returners, we will have a bit of a young team, and we're going to need to grow. We're going to need to close the gap on a lot of those trouble areas defensively that we've had in the past. Our strong athletes need to become dominant athletes and totally outperform themselves from the previous years. Our new athletes are going to have to break that learning curve very quickly for us to be successful as a team. They're going to come into the program, they're going to have a very short learning period, and they're going to have to grow tremendously in that small amount of time for us to be successful, or otherwise it would be a very difficult year.
Okay, you are a California kid. You know, you came here, you're a four-time All-American. When you see the state of California wrestling from you coming into, you know, college in 1999, 2000, what has happened to the landscape of college wrestling in California?
It is frustrating. It is incredibly frustrating because there's no justification for why programs are getting cut. The kind of excuses that university administrations come up with are just appalling. I mean, they're not accurate in any way. They'll say it's fundraising. Oh, wrestling doesn't generate enough money. However, wrestlers tend to fundraise very well because we keep a great alumni base because of the type of sport it is. And bring in money, and it doesn't cost a lot to have a wrestling program. So it is frustrating seeing these programs drop. I'm very excited about Cal Baptist and picking up a good coach like Lenny Zaleski and seeing that they'll probably grow as a great Division II program. And it'd be nice to have that type of competition back here in California. And also, hopefully, that will encourage some of these other smaller schools that want to go Division II to develop programs.
If there's one thing you want a kid to know that you're recruiting about San Francisco State, Mauricio, what would it be?
It'd be that this is a great environment to learn in. We always have a competitive room. The coaching staff is going to grow and develop as well and learn different ways to develop the new wrestlers that are coming in from California. And then we're going to, you know, provide a great opportunity for them to move on to the next level.